Yeah, I got the green light. I always do.
Okay.
Yeah, we're good.
Well, let's go.
We into Shock Your Mock, Casey? Let's get into it.
It can't be bargained with. It can't be reasoned with. It doesn't feel pity or remorse or fear. And it absolutely will not stop. Ever.
I am shocked and appalled.
I am shocked and chagrined. Mortified and stupefied.
So you're trying to play GM and you started a mock. So I go to my boy Money Martin. Oh, we pop in the trunk. We tell the mother. Gonna shock your mock. 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 Gonna shock your mock.
All right. So before we get started today on a very special edition of Shock Your Mock, I got to put it out there to the syndicate. All right. I put out a request. I said, you know, the tank's getting a little empty. We need some more mock drafts to break down. And what did you guys do? You guys filled up the tank, and then you got me a 6-gallon tank on the back of my car and said, you know what? If you run out of gas, we got your back, Austin. And that's what we do. We got about 30 mock drafts right now that have gone unshocked, unverified, that I'm not sure what we're going to do. So I think I'm going to get it to as many as possible. Once again, there's a queue, okay? Respect the queue. Mind the queue. I don't know how many times I got to say it. And number two, you don't get any do-overs, right? It's one and done. Okay, there are no mulligans in Shock Your Mock. So if you already did it, if you already posted one, I'm doing the soonest one that I saw, and then we move on with our lives amicably, yeah. Which is a real word.
Amicably. And queue.
Amicably.
All in the and same queue. Minute. That is very good.
That's because I used to drive Uber, and we always had the Uber queue. So yeah.
That's a great word.
That one was easy.
It's a really underrated word.
Hard to spell, though, man. Hard.
Yeah, Q-U-E-U-E, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Citywide spelling bee champ.
So if you start wondering where to send...
I thought you got second.
Second, yeah. Yeah. Nobody's really going to verify that, though.
Well, too bad. Too late. Casey did. So to those asking out there, because we see it in the chat, you know, we have to address the chat now. You guys are wondering, where do you send your Shock Your Mock to? Go ahead and send it to, you know, my Twitter handle. I'll get to it. I'm foreseeing, because we have so many in the queue right now, that maybe the last day we have a Shock Your Mock spectacular. Ooh. And we just go rapid fire.
Ooh,
just
like
get to the chopper. You know what I'm saying? Like just nonstop Rambo stuff. That wasn't Rambo. That was Commando. Sorry. Sorry. That was Sly Stallone. That wasn't
Schwarzenegger.
Yeah. Schwarzenegger.
Arnold,
thank you very
Arnold.
Much. Arnold. Yeah. So get to the chopper, you know what I'm saying? And let's do a rapid fire. So just because maybe you're back in the queue doesn't mean you won't get seen. We'll make sure everybody gets seen here on Shock Your Mock. So with that being said, let's go to today's Shock Your Mock. And this dude came out. His name is Cade 84. Not sure if he was born in 84. Not sure if he was a former high school receiver. Maybe played in college. Who knows? But he's a... Well, it says Heat and Knowles, so I assume he's a Miami Heat fan and a Florida State fan.
Yeah, baby.
Well, you
ESPN 690, your home for Florida State football and basketball.
Okay, good you said that, because I was about to say something else, and it wasn't going to be good for us, because the Heat are a great team. Knowles got some catching up to do, but they can do it.
By the way, I left it in there on purpose that his location is open across the middle.
I like that.
Oh, so he's a wide receiver.
Yeah. Or a tight end.
84. Yeah,
right.
Yeah, or a tight end as well. Probably a tight end as well. All right, cool. So let's get into it. Shock Your Mock, we got... First pick overall, right? No trades, not getting fancy. Just a good, wholesome, family-oriented Shock Your Mock. Number one, Aiden Hutchinson, right? We talked about him a lot on this show. He seems to be the overall consensus if people are picking number one. Safe pick, right? Could give you 10-plus sacks his rookie year. Could be paired well with Josh Allen. Yeah, there's maybe a little question of how much he can drop back into coverage. But let's be honest, it's a 3-4 defense. You're asking your outside linebacker to maybe drop back, 8 to 10% of the time. That doesn't scare me. You're bringing him here to rush the passer. He can do that. I think in terms of technique, can clean it up a little bit. He's more of an effort guy, but it's all good. No worries. I'm not mad at that pick at number one.
We are working, by the way, on an iBlack sponsorship, if Aiden Hutchinson.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I mean, we've been over that, too. The whole God of War iBlack thing, Doug Peterson shutting that down real quick. Pick number 33. We're going to Georgia. A lot of Georgia Bulldogs been going, but, hey, when you win a national championship, you have that privilege to be on Shock Your Mock a lot. And when we talk about Georgia Bulldogs, we are talking about the one and only Quay Walker, pick number 33, linebacker, Georgia. Ward number 7 in college. Now, keep in mind, I love my defensive linemen to wear single-digit numbers. You got a middle linebacker rocking a single-digit number? The biggest chef's kiss ever. Looks good, swaggin'. I like it a lot. Check this out. If N'Kobe Dean was built like Charmander, then Walker is the final form, and he's Charizard, right? Because N'Kobe Dean, 6 foot, a little undersized. Quay Walker coming in at a gentleman, 6'4", with 32 and 5/8 arms and 240 pounds. Ran a 4.52. The instincts are there. Scouts seem to love this guy. Of course, it's the only question when we talk about the Georgia linebackers. How good can they be not playing with that, you know, up front, where they have the best defensive tackles in all of college football next to Wisconsin? And my answer is this. The dude's got instincts. The dude's got speed. He's big. He comes in right away. I think it makes a difference. I'm not mad at pick number 33. It's a draft need alert, Casey. The last time I heard, I think linebacker's a draft need alert. I'm not mad at Quay Walker.
By the way, I think Casey approved of your reference there during that rant.
That's good.
Who's that?
Oh, I had no idea what you were talking about.
Pokemon. Charmander, yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. But, I mean, tell me I'm wrong, though.
No, you're spot on.
Hey, real quick, who's the one in the middle? Charmander, Choizard? You know, it's like Choiz something.
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever.
He doesn't
Bok Choy. Yeah, who cares about that dude? He sucked.
Yeah, literally, you just wanted to evolve it into the next one.
So yeah, like, yeah. Like, okay, I got Charmander, and then guess what? We're going to Charizard right away. Right?
Because, yeah, you know, Charmander
Forget
was small.
Forget the one in the middle.
And,
yeah,
know,
he's cute.
You can relate to him. Yeah, yeah, exactly.
And the one in the middle is like when you're in high school, you're kind of awkward. You're afraid to ask out the girl in prom because, you know, you got acne and glasses. That wasn't me. It might have been me. All right, let's go on, man. Pick number 6, it was me. There was no amount of Nagzima that could help me out. But in pick number 65, shout out to Nagzima, by the way, cut the check. Pick number 65, we're going to Ed Ingram, offensive guard, LSU, 6'4", 320. Get that button ready, Casey. Scouts say that he lacks the desired girth through his thighs and his calves.
Oh, girth.
Hit the button.
How many times do we have to teach you this lesson, old man?
I love the young people.
Jump the gun. Hey, can we start canceling these scouts? Lacks desired girth through thighs and calves? He's 320 pounds. Where is it then? Do you mean to tell me that his calves and his thighs aren't adequate when he weighs 320 pounds and he's 6'4"? Where is it then?
He's like the guy in the gym that's
where,
like, he's just like ripped up top, and then he's got like little pencil legs.
I guess. I mean, maybe he missed leg day. You know, the guy ran a 40-yard dash. Doesn't really matter, though. He's an offensive lineman, so who really cares? Scouts also said that, and here we go with this word again, he is tardy in his adjustments.
Tardy again. Tardy's a buzzword
tardy,
this week.
Tardy is the gritty right now of old people scouts trying to, you know, have adjectives to describe a player. This guy is all over the place in terms of good and bad film. There's been some great film on him, and then this past year there's been some very bad film on him. He's got questionable power. It's said that he's gonna be a late day 2 or an early day 3. So with all that being said, at pick 65, this is one that I probably can't co-sign on. And by the way, it was Charmeleon.
That's him.
Who we got there.
That's why we have a
thanks
feed.
MM Masters Charmeleon. Yeah, but the long story
YouTube
short,
coming up big today.
No, for sure. But if we're talking about number 65, Ed Ingram, he's a Snorlax, right? Big, but he's a Snorlax. He's an offensive guard. He
look
just lays
up Snorlax,
there.
Brent.
Yeah, go and look up
You'll
Snorlax.
Need that background information.
He's big, and in the video game wasn't bad, no. But overall,
yeah.
I mean, is he dependable?
You know, when his best move in Pokemon was just to lay on people.
He lays
on people,
great. Dude. Hey, he had the slap, and then he had to lay on people.
That was a heck of a snore, by the way. Sleep apnea at its best.
Oh, I can do it, man. Well, you see the septum I'm rocking with here? You know, I got a good snore in me. All right, so pick number 70. Let's go to Alabama now, right? Let's go to John Metchie the III. All right, so Trevor Lawrence, you need a wide receiver, and I understand that. Brent, we need weapons, and we understand that. Doug Peterson wants to be reloaded. Call him John Wick. Bang, bang, bang. Okay, we all understand that. But you got John Metchie right now, who's coming off of a torn ACL. Yes, it's a Trent Baalke blue light special. Hit the button, please. One has to wonder, though, if the Jaguars do draft him, where does he fit? Right? Because you look at his size, you look at his best, you know, his routes ran, you'd probably put him in the slot. If you have a guy in Christian Kirk here, I mean, do you put Kirk on the outside? Do you put Metchie on the outside? And is Metchie play right away? A lot of question marks with that pick at number 70. So in my opinion, yeah. I mean, if he can come and be what he was in college, absolutely. But where do you put him?
Yeah.
So it's hard to foresee.
I also say this because I think we forget about a guy like Laviska Shenault. So if you draft a guy like Metchie, does that even bounce him out to trade him or whatever?
Yeah, yeah.
And we're not sure if he's in favor or not right now in Jacksonville. But to add another guy that can play the slot, I mean, hey. Slot can be a dangerous place to be, but how many do you need?
Oh, and don't get me wrong. I mean, he can play on the outside as well.
Yeah, but where's he
best fit? But once again, you know, I think his best fit could be on the slot. All right, let's go to pick 106. We're going to Florida. So we got some Georgia Bulldogs. We got some Florida games.
SEC.
Everyone's getting along.
It just means more, baby.
Oh, it just means more. LSU, Alabama. Okay, this isn't a Gene Smith draft, that's for sure. Let's go to Zachary Carter. Pick 106, defensive tackle in Florida, Murray State. Defensive tackle, Florida. Pick 106 here, Zachary Carter. Once again, Zachary Carter, single-digit big man alert. Like it a lot, man. A lot of swag. 6'4", 285, ran a 4.99. Said 5 flat, not kick rocks, 4.9, right? Because you don't say 4.99. You just say a 4.9. So he ran a 4.9. A little concerning in the bench press. I know we don't put a lot on the bench press, but for being 6'4", 285, to only bench press it 19 times, is he really getting in the weight room a lot, guys? I don't know about that.
Can he throw bales of hay?
His vertical was 27.5. And then when it turns out that his number was number 6, and you know why it was number 6? Because he wore in honor of Dante Fowler. Dante Fowler didn't really work out here in Jacksonville. Dante Fowler is known more for throwing groceries in a lake than he was actually sacking the quarterback. So there's a lot not to like about this pick, but this guy is super versatile. Don't let the numbers fool you in terms of his athleticism. He can play in a 3-4 or a 4-3, 4-3 big end or a 3-4 big end. And despite what he ran, despite everything, he is pretty athletic. Scout said that he has wide, girthy hips.
Oh,
so,
girth.
So I guess
in a positive way.
So when you got wide, girthy hips, you just call him the Kool-Aid man. You know, he's got those big Kool-Aid man hips. You know what I'm saying? I mean, are there bigger hips than the Kool-Aid man? I think not. He's got little legs.
Little legs.
But he got those girthy hips though, you know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah.
So the Kool-Aid man, oh yeah, coming to Jacksonville. Zachary Carter, pick 106.
By the way, that sound the last 2 minutes reminded me of being at the dentist when you get suctioned out there, you know?
Yeah. Yes. All right, and then the last pick on this first slide here, pick 157, Yusuf Corker. Now, you know how I feel about names, right? We've been over the whole George Pickens thing. When you bring Yusuf Corker to the table, sounds like a Croatian adult film star. Casey, hit the adult film star music, please.
Hey, how you doing? I'm Yusuf Corker. I'm here to fix the cable.
Oh, Yusuf, I thought you'd never come.
Yeah. Oh, what seems to be wrong with the cable? Oh, okay. I'm Jiminy in the switches. You know what I'm saying? End scene.
I don't know who he is. He's from Kentucky. He's a safety. Enough said. Don't want him on the team. Sounds like a Croatian adult film star, and we are done. Next slide, please. If you sound like a Croatian adult film star, you don't get to play for the Jacksonville Jaguars and Doug Peterson. Okay? I'm putting out there right now. So, George Pickens, you sound old, and you sound like you don't play wide receiver, and Yusuf Corker, which cannot even be a real name, you don't get to play for the Jaguars because you sound like a Croatian. I was going to say a different country, but they're going through a lot right now, so I'm saying Croatian adult film star. Okay? We good? We on? Okay. Pick 180. Let's go to Haysan Haskins.
Now I'm trying to think of other names in Jags history that could have sounded like adult film stars.
Nothing like Yusuf Corker. Nothing like Yusuf Corker. I mean, maybe Ashton Yabuti, right? Was it Yabuti? You guys are laughing like I'm crazy. There's Ashton Yabuti. Okay. So why are you laughing at me like I'm crazy?
That's true. No, you're right. Because you're right.
Okay. Well, don't act like I'm not telling facts here. All right. Hey, can we get a little more professional?
We do have a question. How did we get to the Seinfeld music being the adult film star?
Okay. So long story short, I wasn't, to put it bluntly, I wasn't going to type in adult film music on the work computer.
Yeah, good idea.
Because then Will's going to have come a little chit-chat with me saying, hey, we can't look up, and it wasn't
my work. Got a new boss in this week, too.
Exactly.
That would not have been a good start.
Casey, hit it one more time.
Oh, shoot.
Hit the music one more time. That can be in a movie. Tell me that can't be in a movie.
Or it could be on the most popular show of all time.
No, I'm saying, yeah. But I'm just saying, listen. I don't want to go too down the rabbit hole here, but I'm just saying, if you got a groovy bass line in the 1970s,
Yusuf Corker.
I'm just saying, Yusuf Corker, I'm just saying, okay? We're good. I know that's a Seinfeld beat, but I'm just saying that can be associated with something else as well. Okay, so pick 180. We're back on track, everybody. Sorry about that. Haysan Haskins, Michigan, right? This guy was all first team Big Ten, which is very impressive because he was competing with a bunch of Wisconsin Badger running backs. You know how the Badgers love their running backs. First team all Big Ten. Think of this guy as another James Robinson type, though. He's unproven as a receiver. 6'1", 220, didn't run the 40-yard dash of the combine, but it's all good. I got my sources in Ann Arbor coming to me. Ran a 4.74 at his pro day. Mm. Not sure if that was a 42-yard dash, but a 4.74. And I get
terrible.
It.
I get it, Brent. Snow in Ann Arbor.
I mean, it might have been in the snow. Yes. Might have been in gale force winds. It wasn't downhill like they do at other universities. I'm not going to say Penn State. Yeah, 4.74.
I mean, we got like 300-pound offensive linemen running faster than that.
I'm just saying he ran a 4.74. Take the wow. Yeah, so take it how you want. All right, let's get in the next one here. Kellen Deesh. It's funny, back home in Wisconsin, we used to have a thing. We used to say Deesh, like something good happened.
Yeah.
You go Deesh. So like, for instance, say, hey, let's go to the gas station and skip me some Dooskies, Mountain Dew. Hey, did you give me a Dooskie? Yeah. Appreciate it, man. Deesh. So we say Deesh three times.
So how about we do that from like the Volley's House of Cards instead of bang, bang, bang?
Deesh. I mean, you could. But nevertheless, Kellen Deesh, 6'7", 300 pounds, 4.89, way faster than Hassan Hankins was. Comparison actually is Charlie Heck, who has some Jacksonville ties.
Yes, he does.
Yeah, his dad.
Coach Heck's son.
Correct.
Who was drafted Kansas City, I think.
There you go.
Maybe Kansas City. Coach Heck works in Kansas City.
Correct.
Now.
Yes.
So maybe that's why I'm tied in.
He played
in North Carolina.
Yeah. I see you doing your Shocker Mock research. He's athletic, but he's got to put more weight on and have a better anchor. That's what scouts are saying.
I mean, it's amazing if you're an offensive lineman and you're 300 pounds and you got to put more weight on.
Well, to be fair, 6'7 is pretty tall. You know what I'm saying? Tall, yeah, that's pretty. He's probably pretty lean.
Ben Bartsch, give him a call.
Yeah, there we go, man. Enough said. Get on those smoothie regimen. Cade York, next pick here.
But pick at least his name's not Dicker.
Yeah, so pick 197, Cade York, kicker, LSU, 6'1", 198. He bench pressed 225 12 times at the combine. Why did he do it? You really got to question the IQ of a guy like Cade York coming to your team if you're bench pressing your kicker at the combine. Why? Yeah. Why are you doing that? Why? No, seriously, why?
I don't know.
Okay, anyways, I guess he lives in the weight room. Who cares? You're a kicker. But that's all he did. Didn't run the 40-yard dash. Didn't, you know, do the shuttle because, once again, he's a kicker. He was 21 of 27 last year. His longest was 52 yards. And his longest ever at LSU was 57 yards. Mm. I mean, I think that deserves a button. I don't know. You got any buttons for, like, long field
goals? I
think
that was to beat Florida, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, I mean, you got
any... That's me. I think that was to beat Florida, wasn't it?
Yeah. He was 95% in extra points last year and 100% the previous 2 years. So, guys,
do
pretty
you think
consistent.
Cade picked Cade just because of Cade?
That's his name. Good point. Yeah. I mean, if you give him some kickers to love him, the guy's consistent. I guess he's a baller. I mean, kicked 57 yards.
Hey, by the way, if we draft Corker and Dicker, what a moment.
Man,
we'll have to play the music just all show.
Instead of like, you know, the Jaguars come out to some, like, I don't know, whatever they come out to, DMX, it's gonna be Seinfeld, just bow, ba-dum, ba-dum, you know what I'm saying, the whole time. All right, we got three more picks here. We got Jamari Saylor, offensive guard, Georgia, going back to the Bulldog pen again. Jamari Saylor, get the button ready. Said he's got a broad chest with bulbous thighs and long arms. We've had him before.
Bulbous.
How many times do we have to teach you this lesson, old man?
I love the young people.
Okay. We get it. He's big. He's just, say he's big.
I know.
Don't use the word bulbous, because you use the word bulbous, then we start talking about cable in the Seinfeld news again, where someone's going to change the cable. You know what I'm saying? Brent, you probably don't know what I'm saying, but you get what I'm going at here. Don't use the word bulbous anymore. It's weird. It's creepy. Be younger. Get the olds out. All right, next pick. Uh-oh. What did I say? What did I say if this guy ever popped up on Shock Your Mock again?
I'm going to have to crack a joke.
Now, I've already pushed the limits hard enough today, but I'm just saying, and by the way, Derek Deese Jr., San Jose State, more of a run blocker than he is a receiver.
You've memorized his scouting report.
I mean, we got it down by now. But I will say this, without the risk of getting in too much trouble, I feel like Derek Deese Jr., if he comes to Jacksonville, he should probably start his own brand of, I would say, almonds or cashews. And he should have a name for those almonds or cashews.
Sunflower seeds.
You can't do sunflower seeds. Okay. I'm just saying, for his name, you should probably start selling almonds
about, like,
or
pistachios.
Walnuts. But pistachio is not a nut, though.
Yes, it is.
Is it? Isn't it like a legume or something?
What
is a pistachio?
A pistachio nut.
It's a nut?
Yeah, it's in a shell and everything.
Positive.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Well, then, yeah.
My favorite kind of nut.
All right. Okay. Then he can sell pistachios as well. That's all I'm going to say
at
about
this establishment.
It. Yeah. And by the way,
how about macadamia?
He can sell a lot of macadamia, almonds, pistachios,
peanut,
walnuts.
Yeah. Peanut as well.
Peanuts.
Yeah.
Anything else?
Jag's nuts.
Okay. Well, you get the point. He can sell those, right? So he's a good branding opportunity. It's all I'm going to say about him. Okay.
And his name is what again?
Derek Dees Jr. Derek Dees Jr. And last pick, 235. Here's a fun fact. Didn't know he actually played. Or yeah. He had a brother.
He's got two.
Yeah. Aluakunle Badukasi is a linebacker, brother of Foye. Or,
yes.
Yeah.
Foye Fadukasi.
Foye Fadukasi.
Really, Folaranzu.
Yeah, Folaranzu Fadukasi. So that's his brother, plays linebacker at Rutgers.
By the way, both his brothers are, they were teammates at Rutgers. Fadukasi, who now is with the Jags.
Yeah.
Who played for UConn and, of course, now is signed on with the Jags, a big deal. So also something else of the Wikipedia page of Aluakunle Fadukasi.
Mm-hmm.
He has his own T-shirt company called O3.
Hmm.
So there you go, a little advertising at the NFL.
So we can just call him O3.
Now we're plugging. Like he didn't get enough in the NILs. Now we're plugging his stuff.
I don't know if he got anything in the NFL. He played for Rutgers.
No, the NILs.
He
got something. He got something.
Yes.
He got something.
So, that's cool. A little tie in there.
Yeah.
So how did Cade do?
I think well.
I forgot where we he did okay.
You're shocking the mock of Cade 84.
Well,
how
no, because so someone's saying that, according to Google, pistachios are actually seeds. So...
That's not true.
I
don't think that's true.
Try to have a joke, try to have a little bit. You guys had to ruin it because you had to say pistachios, but it's all good.
According to my Google, pistachio is a nut.
It's all good, man. I think we had our fun, and that's been Shock Your Mock. Thanks for K84. Whether you're a tight end or a wide receiver, you're probably on the bench with that Shock Your Mock, so thank you.